all understand this. And by the way,
so unless you talk about it, unless the British public
are allowed, we have been talking about little else for the last 3 months on this programme.
Piers,
I have said many things similar to
you. You haven't. You've been brave.
Here's my point. This is not about me saying everything you say is wrong. My problem comes.
What's wrong? What's wrong with my accent?
Let me finish.
The way I talk, my background.
Mate, we both went to comprehensive schools, right?
You went to a
I went to a state school, mate.
Yeah, you went to a school in Surrey.
No, I didn't. I went to a school in Sussex called Taylor
Sussex,
Comprehensive,
yeah.
Right? Don't play the class card with me.
You know nothing. You know nothing about growing up in Luton. You know nothing about growing up in Luton.
No, I didn't grow up in Luton.
You haven't watched your town decay. You haven't seen. I travel this country meeting families whose daughters have been raped, who are desperate. The British public are desperate for this problem to be solved. You want to talk about the radicalising factor as
no,
to why
I
this
want
attack?
To talk
no,
to
we
you.
Need to talk about why this attack happened. We need to
calm down.
We have to
calm down and let me respond to you. I'm not saying nothing you say has merit, right? I have argued the same points about the Wahhabi preaching in mosques in this country, the extremism. I've urged Muslims, the decent law-abiding Muslims, to root out extremists. My problem with you is that you conflate Islamist terrorism with all
with
Muslims.
No, with Islam.
Well, we've just seen a video where
from
you talked about...
7 years ago, Piers, come on.
The Finsbury Park Mosque stuff you're talking about was 15 years ago. If they're not allowed to be
I've just told you that... Piers, can I ask, OK, what do you know about Islam?
A lot.
OK, have you read the biography of Muhammad?
Yes, I've read the Quran.
Have you read the Bible? Yes, have you read the biography of
which
Muhammad?
Which has more violence in it?
Piers, have you read the biography of Muhammad? What do you know about the Prophet Muhammad?
Which has more...
Just ask me a question, please. What do you know about the Prophet Muhammad?
Here's how this programme works.
You said in your newspaper article yesterday...
You are a guest on our programme, and I asked the questions with Suzanne.
I would like you to just clarify this.
Do you believe, as you did in 2011, that all Muslims are accountable...
Of course I don't.
So do you apologise for what you said?
I've already apologised on national TV. When I left the English Defence League and joined a Muslim counter-extremism think tank, which again in your article you didn't want to talk about yesterday. Now, as I could say, you said yesterday...
Let me ask you another question. Piers, please.
Why am I not allowed to finish
Do you believe
one thing
more Muslims should be allowed into our country?
Do I believe more?
Yes.
How would you tell who those Muslims are, where they come
I'm
from?
I'm just asking you, would you have a ban, like Donald Trump suggested in America, would you have a ban on Muslims entering the country, new Muslims trying to... have a home in this country?
I believe we need to protect the British public right now.
So what's the answer to the question?
British Muslims?
Yeah, we did, yeah, the British public. I didn't say British non-Muslim public.
Why?
I said the British public. We've had three terror attacks. Children are being killed.
Yes, we all know what's been happening.
Yes, I would. I would stop.
You would ban all Muslims?
I would temporarily halt Muslim immigration to this country until we get a grip of the problem. Now, again, Piers, you said in your newspaper yesterday...
It's not my newspaper.
You said in your article yesterday to the national newspaper, you act like I was ignorant and I was stupid, OK? I was ignorant. You have not...
I didn't call you either of those things.
You did.
I said you were violent because you have a long record of criminal convictions for violence. You led a hooligan firm at Luton.
Piers,
Your name is not even Tommy Robinson.
We have renamed
yourself after the leader of Luton Football Club's main hooligan gang, Men in Gear, right? You accept all that, do you? I've not come here
to have a slandering match with you, because that doesn't get this cause anywhere. I want to do a public service. I want to address the issues. I want to talk about why we've got dead kids in Manchester. I want to prevent what's happening. I haven't come here for you to... I could pick things with your history. You've been involved in one of the biggest media scandals in the country's history. I'm not here to do that with you.
I think what you've done over the last three weeks,
you've repeated what I've said for 10 years, speaking better English. And in 3 years' time, you'll be repeating what I'm saying now, because you're all playing catch-up.
Okay.
I have seen this. I'm not talking about what I read in a book. I'm talking about my life experience. I'm talking about growing up in a town plagued by Islamic extremism. I understand this.
Let me just keep this calm, right? Because you are an influential
voice. It's not calm.
You are an influential
voice. And at every opportunity, I point out that you should not attack innocent Muslims. At every opportunity, every single time, I differentiate Muslims from Islam.
Right.
Okay?
But
how can you differentiate Muslims?
Muslims are people. Islam is an idea.
Yeah.
Islam is an idea, a bad idea.
Islam is a faith.
It's an idea that you can change your mind.
No, it's a faith. Like Christianity.
Like Scientology.
It's like all faiths.
Like
it's a religion, it's a faith.
Like Scientology?
So, Tommy,
it's an ideology.
If you're saying that the problem is with Islam, are you accepting that you're Islamophobic?
Because there are 100 verses in this...
Yes or no? Okay. Are you Islamophobic?
There's no such word as Islamophobia. Phobia is an irrational fear. It's not irrational to fear these things. Now, if I hold this book up and say, there will never be peace on this earth so long as we have this book, it's a violent and cursed book.
Can I tell you who said that? Can you put the...
Sir William Gladstone said that.
You wouldn't do that with the Bible. Show some respect.
Show some respect.
Show some respect.
Have you read this book?
For people...
Have you read this
there
book?
There are over a billion people.
There are 100 verses in this book that incite violence and murder against us.
Show some damn respect for people's religious beliefs, right?
I should show some respect for a book that incites murder against me...
Put it down.
An animal. No, I won't put it down. Sir William Gladstone held this book above his head in Parliament, and he said there will never be peace on this earth so long as we have this book. It's a violent and cursed book. Was Sir William Gladstone, who we have statues across our capital city, was he a bigot or an Islamophobe?
See, now Winston Churchill, you're sounding like a complete
Winston
lunatic.
Churchill, no, I'm quoting previous some of the best leaders in this country.
You're sounding like a bigoted lunatic.
No, I'm not.
Winston Churchill, you are an Islamophobe who hates Islam.
No, I don't.
You basically think all Muslims are to blame. We've seen you on video saying it. And what you're doing now is deliberately inflammatory. It is deliberately poisonous.
How is this inflammatory?
And you are having the complete opposite effect to the one that you say you have.
I'm quoting William Gladstone.
You are stirring up hatred. You are abusing people's religion. You're abusing their faith. And you're being a complete disgrace.
What do you know about the Prophet Muhammad? We've established nothing. You are ignorant.
I know that you're
issue.
Deliberately insulting people.
What do you know about the Prophet? How am I insulting people?
Who have deeply held religious beliefs.
And if they're in
and
the,
you flouncing the Quran around in
this
your
book
hand
is the
in
reason,
that disgraceful manner
this book is
outrageous.
This book is the reason we're in such a mess.
No.
That's a reality.
No, we're in this mess because people take Islam, they are terrorists, and they abuse the nature of Islam
and
the wording of Islam,
you know
and they perpetrate evil, and it is completely wrong.
And
for you
how?
To try and claim that the vast majority of Muslims, who are decent law-abiding people, to try and abuse and mock their faith and their holy book is an outrage.
Their holy book. When you talk, when the sacred months have passed, slay the non-Muslims wherever you find them and take them captive and besiege them and prepare for them in ambush. Who's slaying who? I'm not inciting hatred. This calls for my death.
To a representative of the Finsbury Park Mosque. After 7 o'clock. We're going to have more after this break.